The seven-piece puzzle was a game for everyone, old and young, female and male. In this painting by Qing Dynasty artist Wu Youru, we can see several women sitting around a table working on geometrical shapes using the seven-piece puzzle. It was a favorite pastime for the women of the era. The book was published in 1861, the 11th year of the reign of Qing Dynasty Emperor Xianfeng. However, this was not the earliest book on the seven-piece puzzle. Another book titled Collection of Seven-Piece Puzzle Patterns appeared somewhat earlier during the reign of Emperor Jia Qing. It was not a voluminous book, however. It had only 20 pages or so, featuring mostly patterns of animals, plants, and everyday utensils. The authors of both books believe that the origin of the seven-piece puzzle was related to the Pythagorean proposition. The author of Patterns from Qiaofang asserted, "The seven-piece puzzle has a long history and definitely comes from the Pythagorean proposition, which is too profound and mysterious to describe." However, there's another version of how this game came to be created, a version closer to daily life. This version holds that the game came from furniture. This is a yanji, a traditional Chinese-style table. Its design is very clever, as its size can be changed according to the varying number of diners. A yanji table can be seen in the famous classical painting, Night Banquet, given by Han Xizai. During the Song Dynasty, AD 960 to 1279, Wang Bo An wrote a book titled Flexible Yanji Tables. In it, he listed 76 possible changes that could be made to a Yanji table.
那么再传到明代，这个茶几的形式呢，它就变化了，就除了有方条的桌子以外，还有就是三角形的或者是梯形的桌子，因为它的样式有点像蝴蝶，就有人称它为 叠机，叠机那么就可以排列出更加漂亮的，更加丰富的形象。But
despite the change in name given to the table, it was still a piece of furniture. How could this piece of furniture have come to give birth to the seven-piece puzzle?
那后来呢，就是这个桌子搬来搬去是很费事儿的哈，当时一套整的那个。 叠机啊，要有十几个之多，好像有13个吧，要那么多。那么，为了把这个图案排得更丰富、更那个，那么就有聪明的人就把它剪成小板儿，就是把它比例缩小，剪成小板儿，来进行那个拼合，这样呢，后来大伙觉得拼的花样越来越丰富。 就演变成一种游戏了，不为了宴请宾客，就是玩一玩，也可以把它拼成各种这个形象，这个跟中国的这种文化底蕴呢是有很深的关系。
As time went by, the seven-piece puzzle continued to change. but by the late 18th century, it had taken the form we see today. The puzzle Isaac Hedlund saw was a revised version. Assisted by their teacher, these children are working on the seven-piece puzzle to produce an image of a rabbit that they have just seen in an animated cartoon. The seven-piece puzzle helps stimulate imagination and creativity. By working on the puzzle, children learn new things and enjoy happy surprises. The use of this puzzle in preschool education today confirms a statement made by Isaac Hedlund on the importance of mind sharpeners to children's mental development.
视觉的这种几何图形的认知，包括了解，以及这种空间的思维，还有就是这种视觉的记忆，包括它对图形摆了以后，它怎么样去记忆这种图形，然后它的观察，它在每一次摆出一种图形的过程当中，它得不断的去观察，比如说，那个长边、短边呐，然后直角啊、锐角啊，它得去比对那个方向，这样的话，对于它的观察力来说也是一个非常好的东西。然后就我们目前操作来说，主要是一个相对是一个封闭性的，就是说，前期我们是给他一定的图案。 让他去尝试从轮廓入手去摆出这个图案，那就是一种封闭性的这种解题的思路，在后期逐步的把它变成一种开放性的活动，就是说让他去发散，那这个当中会有蕴含很多想象力，包括他自己的这种扩散思维，这个对他都是有非常好的锻炼作用的。